Last July, I found myself in Rio de Janeiro on a beach with 3 million people and the Pope singing a song.
Lord, I come, I confess, bowing here, I find my rest.
Without I grew up near the ocean, so being around the water, it makes you feel like home. But that was about the only thing. Everything else was completely foreign. I remember walking from my hotel to the stage, and you actually had to go one street off because everybody was so crammed on the main street, and so I had to go one block over, and one block over there was not nearly as many people. And so I remember walking. I remember the air was cool, but I was already sweating, getting backstage, and all of a sudden I realized that I was singing right after this moment of silence. And so we were gonna be in the middle of this practice of adoration. I remember standing at the bottom of the steps and praying, and I felt prompted from the Holy Spirit that I was supposed to kneel. And so I remember walking up the stairs, and you know, you kind of walk up and you look, and you can only see the first couple of thousand people. And even they are about 150 yards away. And then it just sort of got black. I heard Jesus say to me in my heart, "You've sung to me every day of your life. There's no real difference. You've done this a million times before. It doesn't matter how many people are here." And you know that, and I know that. So that was sort of, I guess, my spiritual thought. Then my human thought was, I really hope I'm not messing up the Pope for a time right now. It would be a real drag. Everybody really likes him. He's kind of batting 1,000 these days. So I just thought, you know, you don't want to be the one guy who actually sang, and the whole time he's like looking over his shoulder, like, who is this guy? I remember being done singing the song, and I waited until the blessing, and then I just kind of bolted and went back to that street over. And it was when I got back to that street over and just started walking, and I just started sobbing. And I was like, why am I crying? I think I was just crying because I had an experience of the magnitude of the church and how much God loves the church. And I think it's really difficult in these days to be a Christian and to you can stand up and say, I love Jesus all you want, but to actually stand up and say, like, I love Jesus and I love the church and I'm proud of the church. It's a hard thing to do. It's a hard thing to do regardless of whatever denomination you're part of. I was never more proud to be a member of God's church than that moment.
Oh God, how I need you. You're my one defense, my righteousness. Oh God.